I leave you with a dua that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to make when things are very confusing. My brothers and sisters in Islam, there is no doubt that we are living in times in where things are very unclear and confusing for many people. We are living in times of fitan, tests, tribulations, trials. How many thousands and thousands of businesses around the world have closed? People have lost their jobs. People have lost their incomes. People are being tested in their world. And then people are being tested in their faith. The masajid are being closed. Congregational prayers are being banned. Salat al-Jum'ah is closed as well. People that have an ounce of Iman in them, this affects them. But at the end of the day, us believers, we have a different attitude towards our worldly affairs, especially our financial affairs. We know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned, وَيَرْزُقُّ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ, that Allah Azza wa Jal provides for us. For the one who fears Allah, Allah provides for him from unexpected ways. How many times has Allah provided for you? How old are you now? And Allah Azza wa Jal continues to provide for you. So I'm sure that the believer doesn't doubt that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's help and care for him is always there. No matter what kind of tough scenario he goes through in life, and what business and what job and what income he loses. And we know that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَن تَمُوتَ نَفْسٌ حَتَّى تَسْتَكْمِلَ رِزْقَهَا, that not a single soul will die. This is from among humans and animal kind as well, until he has completely taken for himself what Allah has decreed of provision and sustenance for him. And I am also certain that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bi-ithnillah will replace all your worldly losses, all your financial losses that are worrying you and stressing you out. Just reflect over the story of Ayyub alayhi salam. He was locked in his house, sick for 18 years, he couldn't move. And yet after this entire 18 years of sickness, Allah Azza wa Jal replaced for him his family and his wealth. Just have good thought in Allah and be optimistic and be positive. لأن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يعجبه الفأل. He used to love being optimistic and positive. والله سبحانه وتعالى is الأكرم. اقرأ وربك الأكرم. You know what الأكرم means? الأكرم means the one who gives abundantly without having taken anything in the first place. Allah Azza wa Jal gives us not because we deserve it, but because He is Al-Akram, the most generous subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the question to you, my brothers and sisters in Islam, is why does Allah test the believers? Why? Aren't the believers people upon the truth? They worship Allah, they obey the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they read the Quran. Isn't Allah Azza wa Jal able to give the believers a happy, stress-free life? A life free of calamities? Isn't Allah Azza wa Jal able to give the believers victory with the word kun? Wallahi, He is able to do so. He is able to give us a life in the same manner He gave Adam alayhi salam in the paradise. So why doesn't Allah Azza wa Jal give this to the believers on earth? Why the tests? Why the fitan? And why the trials? And why they are harsh and extreme upon the believers especially? You see, my brothers and sisters in Islam, understand with me very carefully that the heart of the believer only wakes up and it comes to life during times of calamity. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed hardships and calamities upon the believers, so that at the end of their journey in this life, they will meet Allah azza wa jal with hearts that have been charged with Iman and certainty in Allah azza wa jal. When a believer is being tested, it's like him swimming against the wave. You know, when a person swims against huge waves, he comes out with two things: with a strong heart that overcomes the fears of the wave. And he also comes out stronger in his body, in his muscles, because he fought the waves. And in the exact same manner, during calamities, the believers come out with a strong heart, stronger faith in Allah Azza wa Jal, and they come out pure, having been cleansed from their sins and elevated ranks in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the question is, how do we manage ourselves in times of fitan and calamities? What is expected from the believer during times of calamity and fitan? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in Surah Saba, وَإِنْ اِهْتَدَيْتُ فَبِمَا يُوحِي إِلَيَّ رَبِّي. Allah Azza wa Jalla, he says, and if I, meaning the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if I was to ever be guided on any matter in life, what's the reason? فَبِمَا يُوحِي إِلَيَّ رَبِّي. It's because of what Allah has revealed to me. Allahu Akbar. Any guidance you want in life, for any matter you're facing, Al-Quran is going to give you that direction and that guidance. The first thing the shaytan does is to turn the people away from the Quran, because he knows this is where their guidance is. So the further away you find yourself from the Quran and the direction and the guidance of the Quran, the closer you are to the evil plan and the plot and the evil whispering of a shaytan. And the greater concern I have is for our faith. The struggle to remain firm and steadfast upon La ilaha illallah. Never ever let whatever is happening around you to interfere with your faith negatively. And never allow it to interfere with your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a negative manner. Rather, the believer in times of fitan and extreme hardship must increase his iman. The biggest destruction is to commit sins during the time of calamities. Allahu Akbar. My brothers and sisters in Islam, I leave you with a dua that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to make when things are very confusing and when people don't know the right from the wrong. It is a dua that best to make it in a time of quietness, in the last third of the night, when the body has rested and the heart has awakened for the sake of Allah and nothing else. There's nothing to do of the worldly affairs in the night and last third of the night. So the one who wakes up is really sincere with Allah. So get up at that time and repeat this dua. Every night, repeat it until Allah Azza wa Jalla's guidance and direction comes to you. And you will see exactly, clearly what's right from what's wrong. And that is the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in where he teaches us to say, Allahumma rabba jibreela wa mika'ila wa israfil fatir as-samawati wal-ard alim al-ghayb wal-shahada anta tahkumu bayna ibadika fima kanu fihi yakhtalifun ihdini lima akhtulifa fihi min al-haqq bi-idhnik fa innaka tahdi man tashaa ila siratin mustaqim. You're asking, O Allah, the Lord of Jibreel, the Lord of Mika'il, the Lord of Israfil, فاطر السماوات والأرض, you're the creator of the heavens and the earth, عالم الغيب والشهادة, you are the knower of the unseen and the seen. When you say this, you know how much comfort and peace it's supposed to inject in your heart. We're in a time where you don't know the unseen. You see, you and I don't know the unseen. So you resort to the one who knows the unseen, to the one who knows what's right from what's wrong. And then you say, أَنْتَ تَحْكُمُ بَيْنَ عِبَادِكْ فِي مَا كَانُوا فِيهِ يَخْتَلِفُونَ. You, O Allah, you are the one who judges between the servants over whatever they are disagreeing upon. And then at the end, ask, what do you want from Allah? You say, اِهْدِنِي لِمَا اخْتُلِفَ فِيهِ مِنَ الْحَقِّ بِإِذْنِكَ. Guide me to the truth by your permission. إِنَّكَ تَهْدِي مَنْ تَشَاءِ إِلَى صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. You're the one who guides anyone you want to the straight path.